Hello and greetings from Iceland. I decided to sit down and do this update when I found out just now that the rate of inflow of magma into the magma sill or a magma chamber under Svartsengi by the Blue Lagoon is more than we have seen ever before. Or as the Met Office just said today, if this continues, the next eruption is only a few weeks away. And that is quite serious for more reasons than before the last eruption. Due to how the last eruption turned out and the new magma dike, those numbers that we are getting now, they could however be wrong. There could be changes in a magma reservoir that you don't know about, or has this something to do with the main channel that controls the inflow into this magma storage? Is that channel getting wider? Or can the change even be found deeper down? And this we can't say. We might get some of the answers soon through some of the instruments there, INSAR data and GPS. But the question that popped up in my mind when I read about this is, how about this magma dike that just formed? That is where the pressure has been. We see hardly any earthquakes by the Sundinukur craters. Like there was some major changing in the plumbing under there. So all the magma has been streaming to the northeast along this new dike that stretches almost all the way to the Reykjanes Highway, where we have magma at 1.5 kilometers depth. And as that is not serious enough, we have a new power line in the making there as well, or on this extremely fractured piece of land. Let's say that this inflow will continue under Svartsengi, and as the magma chamber pressurizes again, will it push this magma that came on April 1st up to the surface? And we are talking about 30 million cubic meters of magma that rust off from the magma chamber to this location. So this is not one of the videos that comes with answers, and it looks even more as a new reality as for the geology around there. And I have to admit, and I have to say, that although I'm not the expert, it has sometimes occurred to me that this main pipeline feeding all those 11 eruptions so far, has it actually been holding back those events we have been seeing? Because all those eruptions have been relatively small. And could it be that all we have seen so far is just a rehearsal? However, there is still a chance that the inflow rate will drop. But the fact remains that it is today way more than we have seen shortly after the previous eruptions. So the next 1 or 2 weeks, they will be extremely interesting. Because what we have now is magma on its way to the capital region. And there are plenty of fractures there for the magma to travel through. So I noticed in the news here in Iceland yesterday that they were covering such a scenario, erupted fissure near the city, or something that I started to cover in 2021. And I have filmed many locations of interest, so this might be the time to find something to do with that footage. Because the greater capital area is at a very unfortunate location. There is no other way to say that. Like you will see through some of the footage that I will show you soon. But I have already 2 other videos in the making. This was just a little extra because if this strong inflow of magma will be the new reality, it will surely have to change many of my plans. Because we would be looking at a way more serious situation than we have been seeing so far. So all we can do is hope for the best. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.